What's up, people? It's your boy Noam coming at y'all real quick with another video, man. Making this one right in the dark for a minute. Doing something real important, so I didn't have time to put the lighting in here. I know some people may dislike it, but it's just a quick preview of my Detroit Lions versus the Chicago Bears. This Saturday, we hosting the Bears. It's a 4:30 game. Detroit Lions. Again, I don't expect them to lose. I don't expect them to win. I'm just kind of in between it. They know what they got to do at this point. It's no given strategy. It's like it was the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Lions got to go out there. Got to play the young rookie-like players. Chicago not going to play us easy. I think we know by now. We kind of made a game last week harder on ourselves with 5 turnovers. So you go in there with that mentality, you might lose out the rest of the season. If you still feel like you got a chance in the playoffs, then go ahead and win. But you know you're not going to be able to do too much of that if you're not able to capitalize off your turnovers properly. You know, this is a spoiler team. Again, this is a spoiler team. They played physical. They just blew out the Bengals. That may have been the Bengals, but I ain't saying they're going to blow us out, but we've been losing at home. They're probably hungry for a win against us. So if you still feel like you're in the hunt for a playoff team, you know, this would be the game for you. If you don't win this one, then you could really call the season over. Because I don't see y'all making the playoffs on 9-7. Some people say you can't even say 11-5, let alone 10-6. So if you still feel like you're in the hunt, then go ahead, try to pull a win. A lot of people want to see Lions at least win another home game. Word today, too, by the way, Aaron Rodgers is medically cleared to return to football action. So we'll more likely see him on week 17, which is against us on New Year's Eve. So you can always expect that game to be crazy. Again, you know, when it comes to the Bears, though, like I said, they got that front 7 pass rush. I think the weakness is in that secondary. We'll see how Stafford plays with the finger again, see how his hands may be healing up. I think Decker's on the injured list, and I know Lane and Swanson, I think, got another concussion again. So we banged up on the offensive line, definitely, man. Not to mention Wagner may still be out. But I did hear word of Adney practicing, I think, today. I think he was practicing full-time practice. So, that's kind of good to hear. Dula is expected to come back and start this game. Don't know how it's going to be. I'm not sure if he's going to come in and play like the running back we hope to have seen. I would like to hope so. But I'm not going to make the expectations on Ramiro Dula right now too high. But regardless of what happens, I still feel like they need to play Tyon Green a little more. And play, you know, just play rookies again, man. This is all it is. Just play the rookies. Continue to progress with those guys, man. The Reese Mavens, the... You know, Davis's, the T's Tabars, the Tyon Greens, Michael Roberts, just play these guys, man. I know Ledbetter gets a lot of snaps. Play these rookies, man. That's your best bet. At this point, why slow their development down? So, again, I'm about to make this video long. I expect the Chicago Bears to actually just come and bring it to us. And I expect us to be an answer to the call. They don't. We have our answer. We'll see what happens. So I'm just going to leave it at that. Shout out to everybody in DVE. Shout out to One Pride Family. And let's try to go out there and take care of business. Saturday game, Primetime TV. All right, everybody. It's your boy Noam. And I am about to sign this one out. All right, peace.